Hello, dear friends, and welcome to Inktober 2019, and the most ambitious project that I have undertaken. I mean, I would say it's a date, but I mean, that's a blatant lie. I've done way crazier things, but it's definitely the craziest thing I have done with YouTube. So I am following the official prompt list, and technically, in a perfect world, I will upload a video every day for Inktober, and will be posting my pictures up on Instagram. So hopefully that works out well, and that will make me really happy, and hopefully it makes you guys happy too. So yeah, without further ado, there's my day one. So day one's prompt was ring. And I don't know, it's really cool. There's some really creepy things you could do, like you could do the movie The Ring. I don't know if I'm like showing my age. I mean, is it retro yet? I don't know. But anyway, it was cool when I was young, back in my day. But yeah, no, I also, being the massive Lord of the Rings nerd that I am, was like, oh yes, it is time for my precious. And then I was like, okay, no, let's go back. And actually, a weird thing that I thought of that my brain went to, and I think that that's something really cool about Inktober, is it kind of does a little bit of a Freudian vibe on your brain. I mean, it could go Freudian. And before your brain goes straight to the Freud gutter, I actually meant his other famous thing, the idea of word association. And the word association that I had with ring was actually a telephone as well. So I thought it would be really cool to do like an old school telephone. And like, there were just a lot of ideas in my mind, which cannot be said for all of the prompts, because I've looked at the list and I've sort of tried to prepare by doing thumbnails and by trying to sketch out some of my ideas, because that always helps if you have time. If you don't have time, I think that is not a huge important part of Inktober, and if you could like hold that thought in your mind, I will get back to that idea. But right now I was just talking about the idea that I don't really know where my mind went, but somehow I was inspired and I was like, oh, there was this great Instagram post by myself. I really like this picture, and I like planned this picture for a while actually, because it is the picture that I put up for my engagement announcement like last year February, and it was a really cool thing that I wanted to do, which was an out of focus hand with a ring framing St. Basil's Cathedral, which was where the merch popped the question, and I said totally yes, of course, dude. And yeah, it was really cute. He did like a cute little treasure hunt for me, and it was very unexpected of him to do the treasure hunt. Obviously, the whole going to Russia to get engaged thing wasn't such a surprise, because that was like high on my list of life goals, because I mean, Russia's amazing. For anyone who is like, why Russia? The question is not why Russia. The question should be why not? Because honestly, oh yeah, and that's just me making great life decisions as per usual. Don't ever do that. Don't ever, ever, ever put your ink on the paper. Okay? May or may not be speaking from experience here. Just don't do it. But anyway, Russia is amazing, and it's got amazing culture, amazing food, and it's just really, really beautiful and really awesome. So yeah, you should do Russia, especially if you are from a first world country, because even for South Africans, it was relatively comparable in terms of pricing. So yeah, it'll be basically free if you're from a first world country. Anyway, but yeah, it wasn't a surprise. We planned it and we were really excited. But I didn't know anything about the treasure hunt, and it was really fun, and it's very, very sweet. And it's amazing, like little yay love story, yay me. And I wasn't expecting it to be anything of the sort. I was just expecting it to be a dope holiday. But anyway, that's where this picture comes from. And I had a lot of fun trying to take it. I mean, wearing no gloves in Russia on Red Square in February is maybe not the best idea, because I had to actually like put my hands back into my gloves and take them out again a few times to actually get the photo I wanted. And there was a lot of color correction because my hands were like literally just basically like cold dead hands, and I didn't want that to be like the message of the picture. But anyway, the point is that was like a dream that I'd had forever, and it was really fun. And I think that I really got excited thinking about sharing the video and sharing the story with you, because it was a really important part of my life. And I feel like this new adventure into arting and doing art on a professional sort of level is a new adventure, and I'm all about that adventurous lifestyle. Look at me being such a risk taker, and then checking the light is off like 15 times before I leave the house. So yeah, but it's an amazing place, amazing culture, and I just really, really, really thought I should share that and give them a shout out. But yeah, I also was thinking about how you plan for Inktober, and that was what I kind of asked you to hold on to in your mind a few rambly seconds ago. And I just wanted to say that I think that the level of what you do in Inktober should be something that is manageable to you. So last year was the first year I did it, and I was still doing my PhD, so I just did like little things every day. And you can see the sketchbook flip through, it's up on YouTube. It was a demonic video to put together and put up. I don't know why, it was just one of those things. And yeah, I think that they were little, they were fun, and they were a great starting place for me. And I spent about an hour every day on them, maybe two. So yeah, this was a lot longer. And spend the time that you have, because it's about doing it, not about doing it like everyone else is doing it. Okay, have fun, like, subscribe, do all the things, and I will see you soon. Bye!